The current COVID-19 pandemic is a challenge not only for patients with amyloidosis, but for all patients with hematologic malignancies and cancers or with any other underlying diseases. However, specifically for patients with amyloidosis, we may face some more challenges. Amyloidosis is a multi-systemic disease that can affect at the same time in the same patient many different organ systems, including the heart, the kidneys, the nerves, the GI system, the liver, the lung. On the other hand, COVID-19, it's not a disease that is only restricted to the lungs, but we now know that it is probably a systemic disease, and we see complications from the heart, from the kidneys, from the GI, from many other organ systems, even from the CNS. Also, COVID-19 may be associated with cytokine storm syndrome, which is associated with a clinical picture that is similar to a septic shock. And for patients with amyloidosis, especially those with severe organ involvement, it may be extremely difficult to manage this cytokine storm syndrome. So patients with amyloidosis may not be able to survive such a cytokine storm caused by COVID-19. The other challenge that we face in the context of the pandemic is the fact that many patients do not seek medical advice or medical help for their symptoms because of the fear of going to the hospital, of circulating in different places. And this may lead to delayed diagnosis in many patients. And we know that delayed diagnosis in amyloidosis may be detrimental for patients' health and patients' survival. Third challenge that is common in many patients with malignancies is the fact that many of the patients may have difficulties going to the hospital to receive their therapy, either because of lockdowns, either because of overwhelming healthcare systems, or because of fear. Many patients tend to lose some of their therapy. So the physicians and the patients have to discuss how they can, adjust the treatment to the current needs in the pandemic.